In this class, we're going to look at how to add multiple columns to your WPS Office Suite document. Okay. So all you need is to start by opening the document. Once you have it open here, you can come to page layout over here, page layout, and you can see multiple columns in this. Okay. So like I've explained in the previous class, multiple columns are very important, especially when you are writing a conference paper or a journal paper. Sometimes the requirement is that you make it two columns, or in some cases they may define more than one column or in a given arrangement of the columns that you may have in that particular paper or in that particular magazine or thereabout. So to do that, to insert multiple columns, all you need is to come to page layout, and you can see columns over here. You can see one column, which is the default one, which is just the single document like you have here. You can make it two columns, and you can see everything is now converted to two columns. You can see this document is now two columns, which is the requirement in some papers. I'm sure you have seen that. You can make it three columns as well. If you want, you can make it three columns, and you can see the document is now three columns. Okay, so you can see three columns. You can make it multiple columns, or you can come to more column option over here. So you can change it to different kind of arrangement depending. This is three, this is one, two, three. You may want it to be left columned, okay? And you may want it to be right columned, just like so. The arrangement should be right columned or the left columned, just like so. And once you hit on okay, everything is now going to be changed to the left columned, just like so, okay? So it's very easy to just do it. You can come over again, more columns, and you can play around with the number of columns. Alternatively, you can do it manually. If you want it to be three, if you want it to be four, you can see you can make it to be four. And once you hit on OK, it's going to make it four columns just like so. If you want it to be 20, you can as well make it 20 depending on your choice. More columns, and you can see now the default is four. What we set is four, and you can see the preview from here. Okay, there should be line between. If you want to have line in between the columns, you can enable the line in between. And once you say okay to this, there's going to be a line in between the columns, just like so. Okay, so you can see the line coming in between all the columns. And I think this is exceptionally next level. You can use it to write anything, any of your content, more columns. And you have the option to define the spacing, the column width and the column spacing. Okay, you can define everything from here. So depending on what kind of requirements you have, and you can apply this effect to a particular section of the document from this point onwards or forwards, or for the whole document, you can apply it to the whole document if you so wish. So once you select, maybe in my own case, I would like to apply to the entire document. And you can just go ahead and say apply to the entire document. And once you say this, everything is going to be taken to default. Now, at any given point, if you don't want to have your paper or your conference paper or your journal article to have multiple columns, you can still come back to the page layout, come back to columns and say one column, and everything is going to go back to the single column like you've started. So I think that does it for this tutorial on how to add multiple columns to your document, be it your conference paper or be it a journal paper. In our next class, we are going to look at page margins, how to add page margins and orientations to your page. Okay, so until next time, thanks so much for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next class. Bye.